anytime that I wasn't laughing, I was getting to shoot stuff or watch stuff explode. Uh-huh. It was just, oh, God, it was a dream, man.
You're listening to What a Joke
with Papa and Fortune
on Netflix as a Joke Radio.
Sirius XM Channel 93.
Welcome back, everybody, to What a Joke with Papa and Fortune. I'm Tom Papa.
I'm Fortune Feimster.
And we're very excited because we're here with our good friend, Jay Baruchel.
Hi there.
Nice to see you.
Nice to be seen. Thank you for having me.
Yeah, thanks for coming in. This
coming
is very
down
exciting.
From Canada.
Indeed.
I love it.
Oh, good. Thanks. That's
you're than you're a great actor.
Hey, thank you very much.
You are. You
are.
Really
you
are.
So many cool projects.
Nice of you to say.
No, Tropic Thunder, Million Dollar Baby.
Yeah.
So you started young.
I did. I was 12 years old.
Yeah. Wow.
Actually, yeah.
In Montreal?
Yeah. On I think one of my first gigs was getting killed in the beginning of an episode of a show called Are You Afraid of the Dark?
You're like, yes, I am. I'm 12.
Yeah. and I remember, I get killed by this monster in a swimming pool. And the director, after the first take, told me that I was too real. And I've clearly never heard that from a director ever again. So I peaked. I peaked at 12. Yeah.
It went from too real to you're a little too much.
Why don't you bring it back, reel it back? You don't swing for the fences every time.
You tell every director, I was really good when I was 12.
12. You're like, yeah, this is television. You know, it's not Yiddish theater. The camera's right here. You can leave a little bit more to the imagination.
Do you speak French Canadian?
I can't. It's my second language. Okay. French is, but yeah, I can speak it.
Yeah.
You've got such a great voice.
Hey, thank you.
Yeah, you're. The How to Train Your Dragon series is just such great. You're so good at it.
Thank
there was
you.
Such a, really, there's like, you know, there's a lot of people that have some success and then they end up in these animated things just because they're a name.
Sure.
But you're really good at it.
Thank
You've got
you
a
very
really
much.
Good range.
It's, That's nice of you to
yeah,
say. Yeah,
really,
it's,
really good.
It's, you know, I was happy to find a way to make this God awful voice I've been burdened with be of some use to me. I'm really the only word is lucky. I fell ass backwards into that. That was the audition I went to like any other audition that like turned into this, you know, over a decade's worth of of work and,
That's awesome.
And a decade's worth of being part of stuff that makes people happy in this pure way. And it's like, and the thing I trip out on the most is like, if you think back to when you're really little, you like something in this kind of all consuming way that bypasses your brain, you know, and when you, as you get older, this, you still feel passion, but it's always, it's tempered by your mind. And when you're a kid, You love stuff, and you will never love anything as much as you loved what you loved when you were a kid.
Yeah.
And so to know that I'm a part of that for a generation of kids is the most special thing. Like even like last month, I met this girl. She's now in university, and she was like a kid when the first one came out, and she is studying animation because of our films.
Wow.
And so that is the literal thing, right?
Like
there's astronauts who became astronauts because of Star Trek.
Right.
You know, and so I don't know what the practical application of Viking dragon training is. I don't know what
I did get a dragon.
Yes. You know, maybe they go work at a zoo or work in animation or whatever. But the point is, it's like, I don't have the words to describe how cool that is.
That's really cool. Do kids ever pick your voice out when you're out?
Usually what happens is a friend of mine will tell me how much, your voice is in our car and in our house all day long. Will you? Can my kids are big fans. Will you say something to them?
Right.
Absolutely. And I'll go and meet them and I'll say hello and watch them look up at me. And like, what the hell is this supposed to be? This is not the fucking
they're
guy
just
from
like,
the cartoon.
You don't
this
look is, anything
yeah,
like
this. Is, and like, well, doesn't it sound like him? And they're always like, I see them nod for my benefit.
They just can't wrap their head around that.
10 years of disappointing children. I'm just like, you did good. You did good.
They're like, what's voiceover?
Oh, and then to try to explain that to somebody.
Yeah.
Like, why, you know, it's just, you know.
Let them believe
it's just
that
pissing
it's real.
In the wind.
Yeah.
Also,
How fun was Tropic Thunder?
One of the best gigs of my life.
God, what a great role.
Yeah,
such great people.
Awesome.
It was like, 4.5-5 months in Hawaii and another 2 months here after. And
jeez,
it was like a combo of, you know, I was obsessed with G.I. Joe when I was a kid. So
right,
I was always playing soldier or cops and robbers with my friends.
Yeah.
And this was that without the weight of having to be serious.
Yeah.
You know,
right.
Oh, yeah.
You know, so it was like I got to play around with an M16 every day for 6 months and run around through the muck and but didn't have to like tackle genocide or anything.
Right.
It was just like we got to laugh, man.
So
and
great.
And it was like Jack Black and Stiller and Downey are just incredible, man.
Yeah.
And so I got to go to work with them every single day. And anytime that I wasn't laughing, I was getting to shoot stuff or watch stuff explode. Mm-hmm. It was just, oh, God, it was a dream, man. It was super, super fun.
You had such a funny character in it, too. You're just, you're like, what the hell?
Yeah,
no.
Exactly.
Just no.
The audience, kind of the audience.
Yeah.
The only sort of normal person there. Yeah.
It was so great.
Yeah, it was an absolute dream. And I got along with everybody super, super well. And, like, you know, Kauai can get small after month five,
right.
But it's a beautiful part of the world, and it was just it was a blast.
Do they have legal weed now in Toronto?
Across all of Canada, it's legal recreationally, so you can fly with it on the plane and shit.
Wow,
so, that novelty never gets old.
Yeah, I know. Just carry it even
Let
if you don't
me
smoke it.
Tell you to bring weed and your carry-on, and to know that if anybody fucks with you, if it gets lost, the airline has to find it for you. You can go file a report, and they have to find. Like,
it's
all
so crazy.
It's the best.
Oh, after just
it's
a year of years of paranoia,
and I said it for years. I was like, because like, I don't have any other bad habits like that. And so the curse of being a pothead was I was forced to consort with junkies and gangbangers and all sorts of sketchy characters from the underworld. And I'd swear up and down, if I will pay whatever I have to pay in taxes, double the price, let me have a receipt and buy it at a fucking store.
Right.
I want nothing more than to do
They're
this
like,
normally.
You want heroin? You're like, no
honestly,
just pot.
Because, oh yeah, yeah, you want it? Oh yeah, what else do you like? What else do you, I don't want any of whatever else is in your fucking creepy little black bag.
Yeah.
Right.
And so it was like October of last year is when or November of last year, whenever it was, it went legal. Midnight, I was on the Ontario government website buying it.
Really?
It was very, very historic.
So amazing.
I'd much rather pay my government for it.
Oh, yeah. The first time you walk out of a shop with it,
it's the coolest feeling.
It's the coolest feeling in the world.
Having someone at the airport, having a TSA person stop you.
Right.
Take the thing of weed out of my bag and be like, what is this? I say, cannabis. Oh, okay, cannabis. Okay, in that case, go ahead. It's like, this is
so mentally
great.
Freeing.
It's so great. It's really, really cool.
Yeah.
It's really cool. I wish I could
God bless Canada.
Yeah, it's just the best.